Good afternoon. Thank you for coming. This is a really big deal, and you're going to hear about from Marco as to why it is. I actually want to tell you why it is, but I can't because it's really their idea. So, but without going into any detail, I'd like to introduce Marco and Sandra Johnson.
Good afternoon. On behalf of myself, my lovely bride, our faculty, staff, and students of the University of Antelope Valley, we'd like to welcome our city leaders, the local media and press, and our special guest. You know, we founded this institution a few years back. We had a number of goals that we wanted to reach. Two of the top goals that we wanted to reach was one was to create and develop positive graduates that can work in our community. Secondly is we wanted to find jobs for our graduates. During these difficult economic times, we found ourselves having to be extremely creative. We've had to design, develop, and create jobs here on campus. To touch on the types of jobs that we've created and the things we've done on campus for our graduates, I'd like to let Sandra talk about that.
One of the things that UAV takes pride in is that we support our graduates. The fact that they took the challenge of coming to the campus, enrolling for school, coming to class every day, and learning the tools that they need to be productive, we as a community need to support them. One of the things that we really, really appreciate about these students and these graduates is that they take pride in their community. They're an example for their family and their children, so we need to support that. It was very difficult because of the economy the way that it is to be able to get them hired, so what we've done is we've created jobs. One of the things that we've done, for example, is our massage therapy. Our contractor, Bob Drury, designed a beautiful spa for our students. We thought, why not share that with our graduates? So we decided to give them the spa for 30 days free while they build their clientele. So they use all of the lotion, the spa, the sheets, the music, everything to give the ambiance for them to feel what it is to be an entrepreneur. So what we want to do is encourage them and give them that confidence that they need to succeed. We'll help them build a business plan. We'll even help them design a business card. We've done the same with our health and fitness at the Parkview campus. We have a beautiful fitness center. So they're able to use that area too to be an entrepreneur. Another area that we've designed jobs for is our culinary and bacon and pastry. We hire these students so that they can use their skills to be able to offer food at our famous farmers market on the boulevard. We also use them, or hire them, excuse me, to also design their foods with all the events that we have at the Grand Ballroom. We've been blessed to also have events at the Pioneer Event Center, and that's also where these students don't just use their skills to cook the food, but they also run the concession stands. Another area would also be for our emergency medical services. Those consist of our EMTs, emergency care technicians, and our fire science students. The programs that we've designed for them is we've opened up a first aid station here on campus. We thought since we have students staying here on the dorm that that would be safe for them to have that kind of care here. So those students are running that department. Another area would be our criminal justice students. Another thing that we take a lot of pride in is that we offer 24-hour security service at all three campuses. And it's our graduates that run that department. So these are just a few examples of how UAV has created jobs for our well-deserved graduates. So once we thought about it a little more and thought, why not think bigger? Let's go to the area that always supports this town, and that's our community. Again, these students are making a difference in our community. They're stepping up to receive an education and become productive for our community. And we, as a community, need to support those that take that challenge. So thank you very much. I'd like to pass it over to Marco to talk to you a little bit about Smart Hire.
Our Smart Hire program, what we've done is we've reallocated funds that we had set aside for various plans here at the institution, marketing, construction. We've decided that we want to infuse this money instead of those projects into our community. It's straightforward. There's no smoke and mirrors. There's no small print. The way the program works is that any employer who hires a graduate from UAV during the month of September, if that employer maintains that employee for 90 days, UAV will reimburse that employer up to $2,000 or 1 month's salary. Hopefully this does a few things. Hopefully it starts a great trend in the education arena. Hopefully it infuses our economy locally here. We create some jobs. And then there are those employers who are kind of on the fence on whether or not do we jump back into the hiring market or not. Well, hopefully this gives them that incentive to do so. We want to take this a few steps further. We have decided to make our conference rooms available for any and all employers who wish to not disrupt their daily functions at their places of business, but they can use our facilities to hold group interviews or individual interviews. We've also developed a website, smarthireuav.com. And the way that website is designed is for any employer who logs on and within a few minutes or so they can register. They list the types of characteristics that they're looking for in an employee, and within a matter of seconds, the available graduates and their resumes will pop up on the screen. Hopefully that will limit the amount of work and effort that it takes for an employer to find a graduate that fits their needs. We have a number of employers here in our community that have worked with our graduates. We'd like to introduce Dr. Ed Barcelona, who can further discuss the history of working with the institution and our graduates.
I'm Dr. Ed Barcelona. I'm a surgeon and a physician who has practiced in Antelope Valley for the past 23 years. I work at High Desert Medical Group, and our students, the students of the University of Antelope Valley, because I'm a faculty here also, rotate through High Desert Medical Group, and at High Desert Medical Group, the nursing students and the medical assistant students are exposed to the different clinical specialties like family practice, internal medicine, and surgery. So we have a chance to observe the students while they're doing their clinical rotations, and we have hired a number of the students. In fact, one of my office staff at the present time started as a medical student, a graduate here at University of Antelope Valley, and she has now progressed, taken the LVN program, and she is working at my office as a nurse. So this is one success story which I can relate to you personally. I encourage other physicians and medical groups in Antelope Valley to employ and or to try out the graduates of University of Antelope Valley, because I've had good experience with them. Thank you.
You know, the reason I love this program so much, it's finally an educational institution that's standing up and willing to be accountable for what they produce. You know, we have a lot of kids out there graduating from colleges that are unable to get a job, and unfortunately a lot of them are not qualified to get a job for what they studied in. And this is getting a handle on that and saying, you know, we recognize that is the marketplace we're in, and we're willing to be something different. We're willing to be accountable for the students that we produce. And I don't think there's any other school in America doing that. Marcos was talking about the interviews, doing interviews. You know, the statistics, the research, robust research, interviews are meaningless. The whether or not a person succeeds in a job has nothing to do with the interview. It's really wasting time. And that's what I tell my wife, and that's what I tell my partners. And I refuse to do interviews, and they refuse to believe me, and they continue to do interviews because it's so ingrained. But I will take one paralegal of your choice, all right? And we can start him or her within the month, all right? But there's a caveat. My wife has to interview them.